I suppose this isn't something I feel very comfortable talking about because it's quite personal. I suppose I had a tricky childhood because I haven't seen my dad around 4 or 5 years. Which is a long time. I suppose it's a really long story, but how did it affect you being a teenager growing up without dad, sort of being present? I think it's when I was younger, I used to think that I would sort of block it all out, and I would pretend that it didn't matter, and I'd try really hard not to get upset, not to upset my mum or my family, because you have to act like you're strong even if you're not, just to try and help, because everyone else in my family had to go through it as well. And I remember when I was younger, it's hard because I have memories from when I was really young. My dad was really, I remember him being, I don't, the thing is, you never really know if your memories are really true or not. Like, you look back and you don't know if it's a memory you kind of made up to try and make yourself feel better. And sometimes it's hard to tell real memories from fake ones. But I remember being quite young and having quite a nice childhood. My dad would buy me lots of sweets and chocolate all the time. It was really nice. My mum tells me that it's the fact that we had a quite expensive mortgage and he would work a lot. I don't think he particularly liked his job, and that led him to be really, really depressed. And I think he really suffered from mental health issues. You know, he had a really tricky, like, horrible childhood. His dad died when he was really young, so. You know, it's hard to make judgments about people when you know about their past as well. I think it's really hard to talk about memories I have because a lot of the time when you go through hard experiences, your mind blocks it out, and your mind subconsciously forgets those memories because they were hard to deal with. I suppose I remember my dad started drinking because he was depressed, and he was a really bad alcoholic, and he used to drink all the time. I remember him he would always get drunk, and it was horrible. And I don't like being around drunk people because of it. Always get drunk, and then every time it was really difficult because we would always forgive him because we'd always know what he's been through and want everything to be okay. And he used to say, "Oh, I'm never going to drink again. I'm never going to like I'm not going to drink ever again." And he'd always keep on doing it. So it was a long time, and we would all put up with the things that he was doing because every single time he would say that he'd never ever do it again, and we believed him every single time. I know I did, but I was young, I suppose. And I remember when he had a car crash, which was through no fault of his own. I think someone crashed into the back of his car, like completely totaled his car, and he had to have like a spinal, I think it was on the spine of his neck. He had to have an operation, and so he was in a lot of pain because of that as well. After the car crash, he was in a lot of pain, so I think he came home one day. I came home one day and was like, "I quit my job." And he used to have a really good job, and he quit it because he wasn't enjoying it because it was too stressful, and he would always be looking for a job. But I don't think he was. He didn't get a job after that. I don't know. I think he's had another job after that, but I'm not sure. So, he had his car crash, and he didn't really. It's really difficult to talk about. How is your
your relationship with your dad affected the relationships you formed in your teens?
Well, I used to really struggle with that. I used to think that it didn't affect me up until not that long ago. I used to think that it didn't affect me after that happened. You know, he did a lot of horrible shit. Like he just went for 2 weeks. He didn't tell anyone where he was going. He just left, and it was really stressful for my mum. My mum's been absolutely amazing. Like, she had four children to look after. Like, at one point, we didn't have anywhere to live. And, you know, now we've got a nice house and she's got money now and stuff, and it's all mum's amazing. My mum's been really amazing for her, and I thought that none of it affected me. Until not that long ago, when it was the first time that I had taken LSD, when I became conscious of my unconscious habits. Like, I realised that I'd met my boyfriend because I saw someone that was damaged, I saw someone that was hurting, and I saw when I was on it that I knew then that I was with him because I saw this damaged person and I wanted to fix him. I wanted to fix him because I wanted to try and fix the relationship I had with my dad. And like, that's why I unconsciously went for that sort of person. Like, I wanted to fix that relationship. And I think even now, even though I'm in my dress and, you know, feel like I want to go for people that are emotionally stunted in some way, I feel like I want to help them because I'm trying to help my dad. And I know now that really I need to fix that relationship in order to get past this, but I can't because he's been missing for the past. He's been missing for the past nearly 2 years now, and I don't know where he is, but I think I would like to maybe try and, I know that I could never fix a relationship, but I'm glad that I had that experience of LSD because you have all these unconscious habits that make you the way that you are. All these things, all the things that have brought you up, you then realise why you are the way that you are, and all the things that have happened to you in the past, you realise how they affect you now. And I used to cope with my dad by just blocking it out. And like anywhere I'd be hurting, I'd block it out. And even now, like, I'm really stressed about work, and I'm really worried that my teachers will think that I don't give a shit, that I don't care about work. That's just my way of dealing with it because, you know, I care way too much, and that's just my way of dealing with it. And I realise that when I'm taking it, I'm trying to show how I feel by not pretending that I don't give a shit, which is what I do most of the time, but I do. I think it's, there's everyone just poo-poos it, like everyone just, it, like LSD has this kind of this massive stigma to it, you know, it's like hippie, crappy, whatever, and you know, it's really helped me, even just one experience, I think could help anybody, and I think, you know, I've realised all these things just through one experience, and it was really important to me because you know, it gave you a different perspective on yourself. I saw myself in a new light for who, you know, you don't see yourself for who you really are because, you know, you're yourself, you're not looking at yourself. And it was really important to me because now I realise, now I can help myself more. It was like I was